Saskia B, and this is Healthy Me with Saskia B. So I thought today we could do a really nice, short, pretty tough little workout. This is really good for really busy people. You either can pop into the gym, but from start to finish it needs to be sort of 20 minutes, or you're at home and maybe your baby's asleep and you don't have a lot of time. I have a baby, so I know. So what we're gonna do is, we wanna actually use any kind of weight. So a barbell weight is really cool. It's also nice because it works on your grip strength the whole time you're using it. So it's a little bit of a weird thing to hold. That's why I really like it. If you don't have something like this at home, because I think most people don't, you can use a big rock from the garden, I'd say a pot plant, but not with a plant inside, obviously. Maybe a big book. It doesn't have to weigh, this is a 10 kilo one. It could be sort of 5 kilos, anything that's quite heavy, you know, when you pick it up, you can feel it. And if you are going to the gym, you should find barbell weights on a rack. In the weight training section, there'll always be loose ones that you can use as well. And you can do this in a little corner by yourself. So it's also good if you don't really want to be in the weight training section and the gym's really full, you'll always be able to get a weight. If 10 kilos is too heavy, 5 kilos, also fine. And then you just find a little corner by yourself. You literally just need the space around you. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do 6 exercises in a row. You don't want any break between them. And then you're gonna repeat that as many times as you can. So it's pretty simple, but quite tiring, and it will work your whole body. So the most important thing to remember the whole time you're doing this kind of exercise is you want your shoulders back, your feet a nice distance apart. That will change depending on the exercise that you're doing. Hopefully you can see my feet. otherwise, yeah, you can get an idea where they are. And you want a strong core the whole time. You don't want to slouch or do anything like this. So that's the most important thing. So the first exercise we're gonna start with is a squat. So you should know how to do a squat. If you don't, the important thing to remember if you look from the side is when you come down, you don't want your knees to go in front of your toes. So you don't even want to squat like this. I don't know if you can see my knees in there. You don't want to do that either. You really want to sit. You're sitting, you're essentially sitting down like that. So that's like, oh, I've got sore legs. but that's the sort of... So you want your feet to be sort of just wider than shoulder width. So not too close like this, then your knees will take strain, but not too wide. That depends if you're doing a sumo squat, but for today we're not. So we're trying a normal stance. Okay, shoulders back. Always look forward, you don't want to go down like this either. So your form's really important. Come down. Always remember your breathing as well. On the explosive part of the exercise, which will be your coming up, you want to be breathing out. So in, in. If you can't go that low, that's also fine. If you've got any knee problems, you don't want to go below 90 degrees ever. So, okay, so you can do 10 of these. Once you've done 10, you're going to hold the weight here against your stomach. Not against, but here in front of you. And you're going to do a nice twist. So this is important that you make this movement really nice and controlled. You don't want to swing like this. It's be nice. This is a great just core stabilizer exercise. Nice twist for your spine. And using your biceps the whole time to hold this weight in your forearms. You'll feel your grip and your forearms will get a little bit sore. Okay, so that's the second exercise. The third one, this one's a bit tricky for some people, I've noticed with some of my clients. It's called a straight leg or a Romanian deadlift. So it differs from a normal deadlift because you're keeping your legs straight the whole time. So you also want your shoulders back. You almost want to stick your bum out a little bit to make sure that the movement is coming strictly from your hips. Your hips is the only thing that are moving here, and you should feel it here in your hamstring. So, shoulders back. You want your legs to be sort of shoulder width apart for this one, and you want your knees to be straight. You don't want to bend your knees, but you never really want to lock your knees either. So you should feel straight, but not 100% locked. So shoulders back, and you just can come down. You should feel it in your hamstrings, and back up. If you can't go the whole way down, that's okay. You don't want to be rolling your shoulders to make sure you go down. Remember, the only movement is coming from your hip. So you can go down, up. If you can go really nice and far down, that's great. If not, as long as you're feeling the stretch in your hamstring, that's really what this is all about. Okay, so you can do 10 of these. We're trying to alternate your upper body and your lower body. So that helps your heart pump a little bit faster. So it helps your heart rate go up. So very good for fitness as well. So that was essentially a leg exercise. So now we're going to do another arm exercise, which is a sort of a shoulder press, you could call it. So you're going to hold on to whatever weight you're using, and you're going to push up. Okay, so remember, on the explosive movement, you're going to breathe out, in, explosive, high-intensity exercise. You want momentum to be your friend here, but you still want to keep the movement nice and controlled. So as always, shoulders back, core tight. And you want to put the weight through your legs and then up above your head. So your legs do need to be quite wide for this, obviously, because the weight needs to go through your legs. So you really want to keep it nice and controlled, but use the momentum of the weight as if the weight is an extension of your arm. Fantastic! So now you've just got one more left, and this is a basic bicep curl. So by now your biceps will already be quite sore, which is why we keep this till the end, so it's nice and challenging, because you've been holding the weight the whole time. So, as always, shoulders back. You can keep your feet just wider than hip, hip width. Breathe out, in. You're doing 10 reps of each exercise, no breaks in between. If you do need to take a few seconds to catch your breath, that's okay, but you don't want to break and chat to your friend. Don't want to do that. So you want it to be nice and high intensity, and remember, because you are limited for time as well. So those are your six exercises. So it's pretty much three lower body, three upper body, sort of. You're alternating them. Then you do your round of 10 reps, and then once you're done, you can maybe take a minute break, catch your breath. Remember, if you are feeling completely out of breath, to lift your head up, breathe your nose. That should bring your heart rate down quite quickly. And then you want to be doing at least three sets of this. So if one set takes you about 2-3 minutes, you should be able to get that done in 10 minutes. If you've got a bit more time, you can do up to five sets, and then that will be a fantastic workout. Really?